Okay, I think it's Q or something that skips the intro animation. Yeah, okay, whatever. Ah, crud. Well, I guess when it crashes, I just lose everything. All right. Well, I already landed on the Addle Rock, so I can just run up there, grab the codes, and leave. Oop, dang it. Well, glad that that was a very shallow part of the water. Right, that's not it. This is it. New exhibit. Radio tower. Okay. I think I'll start something small. You think I'll go to Addle Rock then? I don't know what the ancient Nomai ruins on the moon are or why they were built. You could put your new translator tool through its paces. Ready to get off this rock. You'll be needing launch codes. Best get off the ground before Slate makes more modifications to their ship. Statue looked at me and opened its eyes. Whoa, the statue's doing what? You know what? Don't worry about it. Maybe you should sit down for a bit and take it easy. I'd hate for anything bad to happen if you tried to launch while you're not feeling great. Addle Rock ruins? Okay. And I know there's a radio tower around here somewhere. Gonna have to figure out where it is and land on it. All right, this is where I crashed last time. Heyo, Hatchling. Thought you were taking that tin can of yours into space today. What are you still doing here? Me? I saw something crash over the horizon and didn't like what I was seeing in the pictures my little scout was sending back, so I thought I'd come over myself and take a look. So it crashed. I don't know what it is exactly. Looks like some kind of plant seed, but it's not like anything I've seen on Timber Hearth before. Trust me, I was quite the explorer back in the day. Do you think it's extraterrestrial? Kind of looks like something that might have come off the dark bramble. Whatever it is, it's put down roots in a hurry. I like the looks of this thing, Hatchling, and that's a fact. I think I'll set Marl and Hall loose on it. Best get rid of this mess sooner rather than later, and no one can remove an unwanted plant faster than a tree keeper can. I'll have to get a good look at what's inside the seed first, though. Don't want to set anybody to hacking up a potentially dangerous plant without a better idea of what's lurking inside there. Tuff can help me halt the old scout launcher over here. Obviously, the opening is too small for someone to fit inside, and anyway, I'm not going to blindly stick my hands into something that looks as unpleasant as that seed does. That's a good way to look at lose an arm or two. Blasted seed did a lot of damage when it crashed. I like this crater. I threw a little scout into the seed. You did you? You're telling me it's bigger on the inside than on the outside? This is going to be a chore to chop up, and no mistake. Can we even remove a seed that doesn't have the decency to stay the same size all the way through? Maybe I'd better grab an extra axe or three, just in case. My signal scope is picking up a harmonica inside the seed. Inside the seed? Huh, no one to tell you there. The only harmonica player I know is Feldspar, and they disappeared ages ago. Listen here, don't be telling Nisus about the harmonica music, okay? They'll never let me get rid of this darn seed as they suspect it has any musical talent. You sure this seed isn't from Timberhearth? Back in my younger days, I explored everywhere there is to go on Timberhearth and saw everything there is to see and then some. Trust me, we don't have anything like this. Nah, I reckon this thing's from Dark Bramble if it's from anywhere, Hatchling. Duplicate signal scout all the way over there. Oh, hello there. Mining site 2B. Good thing this species is slightly psychic. Ah, dang it. Ow. Okay. So, down this way. Still amazed by how much ore the Ash Twin project requires. Isn't that the ore that for the remaining towers being built on Ash Twin? The completed towers I've seen are quite large. Now the material for those towers is all being taken from Ash Twin. The ore we're mining here will be used to craft an immensely thick protective shell that will physically seal off the chamber inside Ash Twin's core. They're sealing off all entrances. I hope they have planned a core, Dingley. I thought you had forbidden your apprentice from making puns, Colas. How else would he improve? I'm relieved by our clan's decision to use Timberhearth's ore only for constructing this shell. If, eventually, life on this planet were to evolve to the point of advanced metallurgy, I'm confident we won't have destroyed their ability to create. Ash Twin Projection Stone. My gratitude for the latest shipment, Onio. This ore should be the last we'll need for the Ash Twin project. This is exciting news. Can I offer an extra set of eyes for this final check? Specifically, mine? If my work here is complete, I'd be delighted to help. We'd be grateful if you would. The more eyes, the better. At the smallest flaw or opening in the shell that protects the Ash Twin project could lead to disaster. Once we finish the shell that seals off the central chamber, we'll check to ensure there are no longer any physical entrances. Rami and I will be checking the interior and then the exterior for cracks. Our final safety check. Oh, what? I almost saw something. Weird. Okay, never mind. That was what I hit trying to jump up here, so better to just go around. Plant only village. A seed from Dark Bramble crashed here and it's already taken root. Tectate wants to use a scout launcher to get a look at what's inside. My signal scope picks up harmonic music when I aim it at the seed. I launch my little scout into the seed. Somehow the seed is much bigger on the inside. And now, know my mind ore from this site to craft a protection cell that was designed to physically seal off the central chamber inside Ash Twin. Once the shell was finished, the now my check to ensure there were no longer any physical entrances or cracks. Sounds like Esker is still stationed on Adel Rock. They've been there by themselves for a while. I hear there are now my ruins somewhere on the Adel Rock. No one knows what they are or why they were built. Central chamber inside Ash Twin was physically sealed off by an immensely thick protective shell. Ah, refuel med kit. Gotta manually do that, got it. Alright, there's that thing. Twin geysers, quad geysers. There's the village. There's the... I don't remember what's down here. Oh wait, this is the quantum stuff, isn't it? Grove Shard, Quantum Fluctuations, 3,000, 16,000, Chert's research notes, property of Chert. I've detected a strange signal coming from somewhere within the grove in this crater. It's very similar to the signal emitted by the quantum moon, so it stands to reason the two signals are probably related. We don't know much about the quantum moon, seeing as no one's ever been able to land on it, but hopefully studying the signal in the grove will reveal more about it. Radio tower, where are you? I don't think there was anything interesting in there. There was ghost material, but that's about it. Oh, right, and it goes into the mine. Got it. Ah, there's the radio tower. An unidentified signal nearby, huh? Radio tower. Frequency discovered, deep space radio. Satellite angle 248 degrees, 350 degrees, 40 degrees, 137 degrees. So there's someone out there. And we're recording. Ahem. It's been 2 days since the launch of the Deep Space Satellite, and I'm about to view the first batch of photos. Let the record show that on this historic day, Outer Wilds Ventures has... They're printing! Here they come! Stars above, will you look at that? There's Brittle Hollow, and look there, that's Hollow's Lantern. And there's Giant's Deep, and the Quantum Moon. I'm speechless, completely speechless. Every single astral body in our magnificent solar system looking stunning from every angle in each of these three images, and in color, no less. Now this is art. I could stare at these photos forever. Doesn't Timber Hearth look tiny from... Hold on, what is that? That can't be right. I mean, that's not even possible. Am I interpreting this photo correctly? It's even stranger as it doesn't show up in either of the other photos. Just this one. Well, then there must have been an equipment malfunction, I suppose. Only sensible explanation for it. I'll radio Gabbro and ask them to go examine the satellite's lens for defects. Okay. Quinns, Interloper, Bramble, Moon. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. What is that? So there is a dark planet out there somewhere. Roast marshmallow. Left shift to extend. Perfect golden brown. Despite my checking on them at least 1,000 times over, the images are still not ready to print over in the radio tower. Well, it's like they say, a watch satellite never transmits data. Haha, that's a little joke for you, Journal. No one says that. Someday, I'll have to study the mechanics of how time manages to slow to a syrupy crawl whenever I'm anticipating something. In the meantime, I've turned to Gabbro, a resident expert in leisurely whiling away the hours, who recommends the following. Gabbro's three foolproof steps for dozing off. Light a nice, cozy campfire and get comfortable. Gaze deeply into the serene warmth. Let time begin to slip away as you allow the flames to lull you into a peaceful slumber. If Gabbro knew I'd taken notes, they'd probably think I'd finally crack, but I refuse to accept sass from an astronaut who deliberately burns their marshmallows. Did I just die? Whoa, bad dream or something? You still look half asleep, but that's a negative on being deceased. I know it's tradition to sleep out under the stars the night before a launch, but if you ask me, it makes it all a bit jumpy. What's my mission once I'm in space? Hey, you're the pilot, you tell me. Aren't you pilot types all eager to get up there and explore for yourself? Doesn't matter if you go to the moon or Brittle Hollow or just the other side of Timber Hearth. It's all the same to me. Get out there and have fun. Just don't hurt the ship, that's all I ask. Hey, it's you. Slate said you're blasting off in your ship today. I'm really excited to see the launch. Are you gonna go into space, aren't you? You better not have changed your mind. I want to practice with a pro before I leave. Ah, you're just saying that. But if you really want to practice with me, I guess I could help you out a little. Try to land on one of the geyser pools. Show me what you got. Wow, that was just like the time the external fuel tanks exploded on re-entry. You'll be okay flying the big one, right? Heyo, hatchling. Launch pad is fine, thanks. Oh, really? Dang. Well, maybe someone needs a new porch or something. A big one. Just saying hi before I leave. What's with the radio? Why's that? Sure, okay, but shut up a minute. This is the good part. Is that all true? Heard from Gabra himself. Gabra can be a little fanciful, sure, but they aren't a liar. I mean, probably, anyway. I guess if you want to know if the story is entirely true, you can go to Giant's Deep for yourself. I saw smoke coming from Youngbark Crater up north and figured I should check it out. You can use the scout launcher, just please don't break it while I'm gone. Tech tight. Youngbark Crater, that way. This way? Geyser Mountains. Quantum Grove Crater. Nomai Ruins. I'm a natural at this. Funny, I seem to recall the first time you strapped on a jetpack, we had to come fish you out the new crater near the South Pole. So listen, there's a satellite set up if you need a... Nah, I'm ready for the real deal. Heh, darn right you are. Don't get yourself killed out there, you hear? Not after I put this much work into training you. Hey, look at this! The statue opened its eyes. Bet you wish you'd seen that happen, huh? Me too. We're not even a little closer to understanding what's going on with this statue. Nope, I'm good. Take care. Hey, I was just about to come find you. Look, 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 you gotta see this. The Naomi statue's eyes are open. They, used to be closed. Probably should have started with that. Now they're opened! I'm not sure why they opened, since no one actually saw it happen, but this is huge news! Should someone tell Gabbro? Or maybe Ryback? Oh, stars, this is so exciting. It's making my stomach hurt. Alright, you're not gonna be helpful. Oh wait, hold up. Gonna wanna get these quantum fluctuations noted in the oscillator thing. There we go. So I guess that child's only there on your first loop. What else should I do before liftoff? I think your friend Hal is in the observatory waiting to see you off. Deep space radio. Oh, engage autopilot. Accelerating towards destination, engaging retro rockets. Now, where'd it go? Autopilot complete. These signal satellite. Suit up. Jetpack, auto boost, translator auto equip, freeze time while translating tests, freeze time, da da da. Freeze time while talking to others. Okay. Gabbro here, checking in on the deep space satellite for ground control's request to check out a possible equipment problem. See, Hornfels? I do too work. You know, I wouldn't mind being a satellite. It's peaceful out here, among the distant stars and the soft, velvety darkness. But it's... ugh. Awfully nice for naps, too. Oh, right, the lens. Alright, little satellite, let's see what the trouble is. Huh. Everything looks A-okay, ground control. No dust or scratches on the lens, and no evidence of sparkling or violent explosions. Guess that rules out an equipment malfunction after all. Hear that, pal? You're in great shape. Keep up the good work out here. I forgot which angle it is that the planet arrives. If I keep watching long enough, I should just run into it or see it at some point. Of all travelers' instruments simultaneously with your thingamajig. Well, I don't think I've seen the anomaly yet. Render the deep space satellite inoperable. Whoops. Well, I didn't mean to do that. Ah, there's the radio antenna. All right, so where's the damage? Porthole. Which one's port? Yeah, it's probably on top. Okay, this one is 40 degree angle. This is 350 degree angle, and this is 248. Quantum Grove, Quantum Moon, Radio Tower. Here, Gossam has the zero G cave. Nami Ruins. Esker is still stationed on the Edel Rock. Central Chamber, physically sealed off. Now we mined ore. My lunch mine. Okay. The moon, drained rock. Ooh, what was that? Oh, it was the arrow. Whoa, what is this? Oh, it's the Edel Rock. All right, deep space radio. Twins, the sun. Giant's Deep. Dark Ramble. Brittle Hollow. Thank you. I almost saw it. And no, you are not what I'm trying to lock onto. I mean, I guess I might as well. What are you? Oh, you're the Quantum Moon, aren't you? Dang it. Quantum Moon. I was able to land on the surface of the Quantum Moon. There's more to explore here. Unidentified signal nearby. Quantum Moon. Whoops. I seem to have lost my ship. Thank you. The interloper. This is troublesome. It seems the comet wishes to submerge our shuttle in ice. If we stay on the surface too long, the shuttle may freeze entirely. If it did, couldn't someone call it back home to the gravity cannon on Ember Twin? Yes, but the exploration of the comet would be more difficult if we were without the shuttle until someone recalled it. Perhaps we shouldn't have landed on the dark side of the comet. Suppose one of us remained in the shuttle to keep it warm and continue monitoring the surface. That would be wise, I think. Clary, if you don't mind waiting here with it, Poke and I can continue to investigate the surface. I don't think I see anything interesting on here. Gravity cannon. There's more to explore here. There were three Nomai aboard the shuttle. One of them stayed behind to keep the shuttle warm while the other two explored the interloper. Nomai that's frozen on the interloper can be called home to the gravity cannon on Ember Twin. Right, where was that thing that only showed up as a shadow on the image? Well, that went off into the distance. Alright, as soon as the image starts coming up from the bottom, that's when I can start hitting shift. That'll send me upward relative to my current position and hopefully lock the shadow in place before it can start evaporating. Thank you. Dang, doesn't look like I'm going to be able to do it this time. That could have gone better. Oh. It really meant it when it said hull damage. Alright, so getting to the satellite early was the right idea. That way. Thank you. Aha, there it is. Error unknown language. So we got some flying saucers there. Thank you. Okay. Don't see anything else here except for that. Oh, well, okay, that explains it. Fuel level is critical. Is this the same one or no? Oh. So shining the flashlight on this makes it rotate. Ah, dang, missed it. Oxygen refilled. Ship log updated. Well, that almost worked. There's a ghost matter there. Unknown language. Oh, okay. Well, I get how the raft works now. Well, that's unfortunate. All right, need to get here earlier, or else I'll Just have the entire thing have collapsed by the time I get to explore. Dang it. Vitals low. Too bad I didn't bring the ship inside. Not that I think it could have fit through those doors. Got it. Okay, yeah, this is the exact same thing as the other building. All right, so this lantern is clearly broken. Slide reel. Oh, crud. Okay, there are electrical cables in here. Good to know. Hey, hold up. Yeah, I already know about the launch codes. What? No, I was going to tell you about using the ship log to set destination markers for locations you've visited before. It's a brilliant feature, if I say so myself. Dead useful. And the risk it poses of shorting out the fuel regulator and causing the ship to explode is so minimal that only Gosen would worry about it. How minimal are we talking? Minimal! Stars above, you worry too much. If anything's going to kill you, it's the autopilot. Wow, Slate! How do you come up with these incredible ideas? Oh, I do the best I can with what I've got. Really, you're too kind. This was extraordinarily convenient timing. Thanks. Sure thing, Hatchling. Anyway, I've got a fire to enjoy and you've got launch codes to grab. Go wild with the marking feature while you're out there. Just, try not to follow it so directly you fly into the sun, okay? Stranger, River Lowlands, Cinder Islands. A radio tower designed to receive photos taken by deep space satellites. There are several photos of the entire solar system hanging on the walls. Hornfeld noticed something strange in one of the photos, but concluded equipment malfunction was the only sensible explanation. A massive artificial ring world hidden within some sort of cloaking field. It does not appear to be Hearthian or Gnomian in origin. A pair of small rocky islands connected by a village of stilt houses. I found a large metal symbol inside a burned out building that closely resembles the now my symbol for the Eye of the Universe. A low lying region near the entrance to the Stranger. There are wooden buildings along the banks of the river. Ah, the dam. Crud. Well, that was unfortunate. Planet, I, laboratory, weird thing. I, the universe. Ship log updated. All right, and here's another one. Hmm. That better not be the dam breaking already. Okay, that's just the other side. That's a fairly large solar panel. Yeah, this one's broken. Broken. That lantern. Family portraits. There's a secret entrance underneath this thing, whatever it is. Maybe these ones will be in better shape. So those were the first two locking mechanisms. Dang. My time is over. There's a railing. Well, good thing there's a lamp on this one already. Staff, portrait. Too bad this house is already destroyed. I just gotta find wherever they hid the tape. It was probably in the part of the house that got washed away. Or I guess unwashed away, since this is apparently the part that was being held up with water from the dam. So all of this is a lower water level than required for its continued function. Okay, so it was sunk. But now that this entire area is deflooded, that sinking is undone, theoretically. Well, getting over there is a no-go. I did not take any notes. Well, there's a reason I record these things.
so.
There are definitely buttons to rotate the camera. I just can't read them because they're so small. Okay, tool x-axis 1, 4, 3, 2. Got it. I don't know if I can actually identify what those symbols are. Oop, and there goes that thing. An enormous reservoir with wooden piers and buildings on both shores. Slide reel that shows a strange vault being encased in a large metal structure and lowered underwater. Nearly all the slides have been burned and cannot be viewed. According to the slide reel, a strange vault was encased in a large metal structure and lowered underwater. Slide reel from the lower river lowland showed a strange vault being closed and sealed with chains and a glowing symbol. Slide reel from the Cinder Island showed a glowing symbol and chains appear around a strange vault. Slide reel that shows the stranger's inhabitants analyzing an anomaly that closely resembles the Naomi symbol for the Eye of the Universe. Several slides have been burned and cannot be viewed. Found a projection that revealed a cave entrance at the base of a rocky island with a tall tower. Slide reel that shows the origin of the stranger and its inhabitants. Several slides have been burned and cannot be viewed. There's more to explore in the low-lying region near the entrance to the stranger. And there's more to explore there. Okay. Stranger, Quantum Moon, Brittle Hollow, Giant's Deep, Hollow's Lantern, Dark Bramble, Interloper, Ember Twin, Ash Twin. Alright. We have liftoff. All breach detected. Ah, dang. All right, tall structure. Looks like that might be it. Gotta find one of those projectors. Okay, never mind, that did not work. Oh wait, hold up. Yeah, right there would work. Dang it, it only takes me to this church. Right, we got the lanterns there, and we got the projector here. Ow. Stairs, come on. Okay. Well, I know I've seen more than one of those, that's for sure. Whoop. Ah, frick. The downside of going in with no health. A tower that sits atop one of the cinder aisles. The upper floors can only be reached from a second entrance at the back of the tower. Find a slide reel that shows the stranger's inhabitants opening a secret passage in a round room filled with lanterns and murals. The inhabitants are shown filing into three of these rooms throughout the stranger. Alright, River Lowlands and the Reservoir. Oop, dang it. That roof was very slippery. Hey, you know what? I think I'll call it there.